What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Say you have a pizza delivery business. To represent and implement the different transactions you offer, you went with a pizza class along with a pair of subclasses, the pepperoni pizza and the veggie pizza. Now your pizza business boomed and you found the need to extend this class hierarchy to incorporate both the American and the Italian way of preparing pizzas. So you plan to create American and Italian pizza subclasses. However, since you already have two subclasses, you'll need to create four class combinations, such as American pepperoni pizza and Italian veggie pizza, and so on. Adding new pizza types and ways of preparing these pizzas to the hierarchy will grow it exponentially. For example, to add a chicken pizza, you'd need to introduce two new subclasses, one for each way of preparing it. The further we go, the worse it becomes. This problem occurs because we're trying to extend the pizza class in two independent dimensions, by the type of the pizza and by way we are preparing the pizza. That's a very common issue with these class inheritance. One way to fix this problem is to switch from inheritance to composition. What this means is you extract one of the dimensions into a separate class hierarchy, so that the original classes will reference an object of the new hierarchy instead of having all of its state and behaviors within one class. Following this approach, we can extract the way of preparation related code into its own class. Let's name it Restaurant, with two subclasses, American Restaurant and Italian Restaurant. A pizza object can now be added as an attribute inside this newly created class. The reference we just added will act as a bridge between the pizza and restaurant classes. From now on, adding new pizzas won't require changing the restaurant hierarchy, and vice versa. Now when the user wants to call the deliver method, all they have to do is provide the type of pizza they want to the restaurant they wish, and that's it. On top of this, they now have the flexibility to easily switch between pizza types as well as restaurant types at runtime. The implementation we applied reflects the bridge design pattern. This pattern is a structural design pattern that lets you split a large class or a set of closely related classes into two separate hierarchies, which can be developed independently of each other. Now, in the Gang of Four book, these two hierarchies, which in our case are the restaurant and the pizza hierarchy, are referred to as abstraction and implementation, respectively. When we say abstraction, we mean a high-level control layer. This layer isn't supposed to do any real work on its own. It should delegate the work to the implementation layer. Note here that we're not talking about the interfaces or abstract classes we know in Java. These aren't the same things, only the same word is used to represent them. Abstractions in the context of the bridge pattern can be represented by a certain user interface, and the implementation could be the underlying code which the UI layer calls in response to user interactions. Okay, now that you have an idea on how to implement the bridge pattern, let's take a look at its actual structure or class diagram. The first classes you may have noticed are the abstraction and the implementation we were just talking about, and which were represented by the restaurant and pizza classes. The abstraction provides high-level control logic. It relies on the implementation object to do the actual low-level work. Whereas the implementation declares the interface that's common for all concrete implementations. The abstraction may list the same methods as the implementation, but usually the abstraction declares some behaviors that rely on the operations declared by the implementation. Next are the concrete implementations, which were represented by the pepperoni pizza and veggie pizza classes. These classes contain behaviors specific to each implementation logic. Additionally, you can see the refined abstractions classes, which provide variants of the control logic. Like their parent, they work with different implementations via the general implementation interface. Finally, you have the client, which is usually only interested in working with the abstraction. However, it's the client's job to link the abstraction object with one of the implementation objects. So, to sum everything up, the bridge design pattern allows you to divide and organize a single class that has multiple variants of some functionality into two hierarchies, abstractions and implementations. By doing this, the client code won't be exposed to the implementation details as it will work only with high-level abstractions. Additionally, on top of applying the single responsibility principle, you will be applying the open-closed principle as you can now introduce new abstractions and implementations independently from each other, making it very easy to switch between these implementations at runtime. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.